Hey guys, welcome to another video, and in this video today I'm going to give you a 5-item checklist that you should follow after buying any Android smartphone. I will also explain why these steps are important, so don't forget to stay till the end of this video. Let's get started. Okay, so number one is enabling USB debugging. Now this step is important because after you have enabled USB debugging, you'll be able to connect to your computer and send ADB commands to your computer. So if you have this enabled, in most cases you might be able to repair a device if it has any kind of a software break. Okay, so to enable Android debugging, the first thing that you need to enable is developer settings. To enable developer settings, the first thing that you need to do is go into the settings option of your phone, scroll down to the about phone section, and in the about phone section find the option that says build number. Keep tapping on the build number option 7 to 10 times until you see now you are a developer. Once that comes up, go back and hit on the developer options. That is a new option that will come up. So in the debugging section, check the box or slide the option that says USB debugging. Once you do that, you will be getting a new prompt saying allow USB debugging. Just click on OK, and with that you will be done and your Android debugging or USB debugging will be enabled. The second item on this list is reducing the time of your animations. So how this helps is that on reducing the time of your animations by half, you not only make the animation smooth, but you also make the phone feel much more smoother and responsive to touch and different actions. So to get started, again, you have to go to the settings page of your phone. Again, once you're in the settings page, go over into the developer options. Now scroll down until you see the place where it says drawing. So in the drawing, goes down to the window animation scale. So there are three options, as you can see: window animation scale, transition animation scale, and animator duration scale. So set all these durations to 0.5x from the default of 1x. If you make it slower than that or faster than that, it might get unnoticeable, so the animations might go unnoticeable. If you want to completely turn off animations, you can just hit on animation off, but 0.5x is the most recommendable limit for your animations. Okay, so the next item on our list is giving the Find My Device option on your Android phone the device administrative privileges. So how this helps is that even if your device gets stolen or lost, you might be able to trace the device, ring the device, or erase the device remotely from your desktop or laptop browser just by logging into the same Gmail or email ID that you have signed in on the phone. So to enable this, the first thing that you need to do is go into the settings option of your phone again. So once you're in the settings option, go down and to security, and in the security, just head down to device administrators. In this, you'll find an option called Find My Device. Make sure you click the box and activate it. So with that, you have given device administrative privileges to Find My Device. So the next item on our list is removing the bloatware that is present on your Android phone. Usually, almost all the Android phone comes with some kind of bloatware, either from the manufacturer or from apps from Google that you might never use, like, you know, Google Play Movies or Google Play Magazine, etc. So to remove this, the first thing that you need to do is go into your app launcher, and there will be some apps that you might be able to uninstall, so just hold on those app icons and just drag them to the top until you see the uninstall, and you can drop the app icon on the uninstall icon to just uninstall the app. However, there are also other apps that cannot be uninstalled. For those apps, what you need to do is get over into the app, hold and drag it up into app information. So once you're on the app information page, just go ahead and click on the disable app. So that will pretty much remove all the bloatware from running on your device. So some of them will be uninstalled. The ones that do not get uninstalled, like the Google apps, can just be disabled and the apps will be never updated and they will never run in your background. The fifth and the last item on this list would be two things that we need to do inside the Google Play Store app. So to get started, just open up the Google Play Store app. And inside the Google Play Store app, go to the hamburger menu and go on settings. Once you're in the settings, go ahead and disable auto updates. So what this does is it disables auto updates so that you can save mobile data when you are on outside and just update these apps only when you wish to, like maybe at night when you keep the phone to charge overnight. So even if you disable auto updation of apps, you'll still get notifications when there are updates for apps from the Google Play Store. So the step number two in the Google Play Store is head over down and uncheck the option that says add icon to home screen. So what this does is Whenever you install a new app, a new icon is created in your home screen, which is kind of annoying. So if the same applies for you, you can just untick that box and then you're just good to go. So that's pretty much it from this video. And as I mentioned before, all these steps are important not only for the smooth and efficient functioning of your device, but also for the security of your newly bought Android device. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button down below. And if you'd like to see more videos of this kind, consider subscribing. If you want me to do a similar 5-item checklist for a new iPhone, a MacBook, or a Windows laptop, don't forget to mention it down in the comments below. And as always, I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.